Safety is the most important aspect of every job in the woods.
I could really go for a grilled cheese right now, I'll tell you what.
Hey, we're rolling.
I'm your host, Jack Isenhart, head president of the Oregon Department of Firework Safety, and some other stuff, but it is a little known fact that I am also the second coming of Paul Bunyan.
And I'm Walter Seals.
Walter Seals, everyone.
Walter Seals, local logging legend.
And today, we have a great program in store for you. Fire, logging, safety, and you.
Logging.
Walter, I thought... Now we're going to take you back a little history lesson. Hop in your time machine. Doop, 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 doop. Okay, we're here, 1915. Now, at this age, Walter Logarithm Seals is a spry 7 years old. And every winter, because houses were made out of mud, grass, and sticks back then, the rain would fall, the house would fall to the ground, and they'd hide in a cave. But at that age of six, spry young Walter decides, hey, I'm gonna find one of those big flowers and chop them down. They'd become known as trees later. But he cuts them down, slices them up like a piece of ham, and then he makes a house out of it. 15 years later, we got logging, the biggest, best industry in the whole wide world. Let me tell you something. Oh, hey, didn't see you there. We joke around. Well, no, reality, logging is one of the most dangerous industries in all of America, second only to accounting and shark attacks. And that's why it is absolutely important that you watch this video, or you will die.
I died back in 1970.
It's okay, Walter. It's okay. All right, now one of the first things you're gonna wanna do before you go start out into the woods, cutting down some timbers, you're gonna be in the right gear. Because if you got the right gear on, then you know you're gonna be safe. So first off, I always pack a hard hat. Okay, that hurt a little more than I was expecting. Oh, yeah.
That's hard.
We're gonna take that off. And then I also got these gloves here, and that's gonna protect my hands from the things. Now, one of my most important things I like to rep is these chaps right here. Now that's gonna protect me from any time I'm sawing and I accidentally cut through the wood and I don't chop my leg off. Now, I got these chaps from a Party City. We were the village people. Oh, that was funny. That was real funny. All right, well, let's get to work. Now that we're all geared up, we can start working with hot chainsaws. Kidding. Well, it's a little known fact, Walter actually invented the chainsaw. Ain't that right, Walter?
Where am I?
Hey, Walter, buddy, why don't we go sit down over there, huh? No, but important things to know about the chainsaw, you're gonna want a sharp chain, a tight chain, you wanna be full of gas and oil. And those are pretty much interchangeable. You can just put whatever you want where. But when you start this chainsaw, we're gonna flick this into the on position. And then we're gonna put a bar like this so we have full torque in our back. And we're gonna... All right. Hey, Walter, how about you give me some space, buddy?
Yes, sir.
How about you back up? All right. All right, now we're geared up. Let's go start this chainsaw. Let's get it!
You got it?
Hey, Jack. Jackie boy. Hey, Jack.
Okay, so we had a little oopsie back there. But we're gonna get her started.
Born and I worked in the hay. Got trapped by a girl, but I wiggled free. Heard the Oregon timber calling me. Will you tell me something, Mr. Lumberjack? Is it one for forward and three for back? Is it two for stopper, four for go? Boy, ask a whistle punk, I don't know. Well, I learned this fact from a logger named Ray. You don't cut timber on a windy day. Stay out of the woods when the moisture's low, or you ain't gonna live to collect your dough. Will you tell me something, Mr. Lumberjack? Is it one for forward and three for back? Is it two for stopper, four for go? Boy, ask a whistle punk, I don't know. Well, you work in the woods from morning to night. You laugh and sing and you cuss and fight. On Saturday night you go to Eugene. And on a Sunday morning, pocket.
Now that our logs are all cut up, it's time to get splitting. Watch the master at his craft. Sometimes it takes me a couple tries. Oh, come on, wood. You know you want it. Oh, bunya!
You want me to take this one over?
I gotta make a trip to a friend's house real quick. So desperate times call for desperate measures. So Walter and I went and borrowed a hydraulic splitter from a friend. Borrowed it. It was borrowed.
Legally.
Your splitter's missing? I don't know, Dave. If I see it, I'll let you know. No, that's not the sound of the splitter in the background. I'm making ramen. I am! Now, you're gonna wanna be very careful when you're using this hydraulic splitter, because that thing's got some hydro power, if you know what I'm saying. So if you're coming down, you wanna make sure your hands are clear. Not a Walter Cheddar Bay this. Your head, it's severely damaged.
Please take me to the hospital.
Please, Greg. Please.
I love you so much. I'm so sorry, you're gonna die!
Call 911!
It's too late!
My hand!
Call an ambulance! Oh, please!
You were always like a father to me.
Yeah, you were like the son I had!
I'm so sorry. Drive home safe, everybody!